so fortunate to have been blessed when on those rare occasions we meet someone like Neda who truly touched our hearts. It was written in the Illuminata, opening up to the pain of death, our own, and that of someone we love, is one of the most mysterious blessings of life. A paradox, really. Nothing focuses us more clearly on what matters and helps us drop our own defenses more quickly or gives us more compassion for human suffering. Painfully shy she was. I was here just a few weeks ago. She invited me to come out for the eclipse. I mean, we had to see that together. And we had such a wonderful time together. And we spent a lot of time reminiscing about our childhood, and she reminded me that she had failed in kindergarten because she wouldn't talk. That's something many of you and it's the truth. My parents had to remove her from school because they didn't know what to do. Maybe she was preparing a long speech for later. We were very close growing up and remained so our entire life. Until we graduated high school and left home, we shared a bedroom and a double bed. In that bed, we had a pinch line down the middle in case one of our all of our lives, we were both committed to a sense of fairness in life. Maybe that's where it started, I don't know. But in that room, we shared sister secrets and read movie magazines and fantasized and actually practiced how to set our hair with bobby pins so we would look like Betty Grable. And we smoked cigarettes and quickly shoved the ashtray under the bed when we heard our mother's and then she would say, girls been smoking, and we would say, no. Neda never liked her name because people didn't know how to pronounce it. She would, she said they often pronounced it Meta, as in Metamucil. In later years, after they moved to Jackson, she was very proud of the fact that, as far as she knew, she was the only Neda in Wyoming. Did she tell some of you that? She was also pleased when her dentist got a new dog and wanted to give it an old-fashioned name, so they named it Neda. We grew up in a family that had traditional roles. She and I learned to cook from our mother, who was a fantastic cook. We jointly changed the beds every Saturday, hung the wash clothes outside on the lines of clothespins on Tuesday, and we darned socks, and we learned to speak Danish by listening. My parents were immigrants from Denmark, my father, but so we learned to speak Danish by listening to them when they were talking about us. They didn't want us to know what they were saying, and so we then enjoy talking about other people, often in their presence. In I'm sure that we had disagreements and differences, but truly, I can never remember fighting with each other or being estranged in any way. Since she was the oldest, I found it sometimes rather interesting that she always looked up to me. She was my most ardent supporter and in everything that I did. After we married and had children, we both lived in Illinois for a time, and our parents, near our parents, and we loved the family gatherings, sharing parenting tips and exchanging recipes. It was one of the last things she did. She sent me, just the day before she, I mean, I guess it was after she died that I got the letter with her favorite recipe for salsa. The poet Mary Oliver, in her poem, When Death Comes, wrote, I don't want to end up simply having visited this world. She was a mover, a shaker, and she made things happen. She lived with intention. If someone needed a job or a place to live, she made it her business to help them find them. She was the force behind helping my son Jim introduce his Adirondack furniture to the Jackson Galleries, a chance meeting on an airplane when she was seated next to Phil, who rode out here today, resulted in her becoming the Peach Lady and the annual Peach Sales fundraiser for this Presbyterian church. If she knew your birthday, you could be assured that you could receive a card or a gift or something from her kitchen. I could go on and on. Maida was not just a visitor to this world. She was the most organized person I have ever known. My family and I have been staying at her house these past few days, and it's almost as if she still is there. The refrigerator when we arrived was neatly organized. Every key is marked for what it's used for. Her closets are amazing. Her datebook has every activity and appointment listed up through this year. She was clearly not planning to leave us soon. Even though after her passing, Linda discovered the folder and notes spelling out her wishes. And as it has already been mentioned, she wrote her own obituary. And this is rather interesting because she requested a very small service. She told me, there aren't very many people left who even remember me. And she said, I would like it to be in the chapel, just the family, maybe a couple of close friends. Then she added, she would concede to having it in the sanctuary should the unlikely need arrive. Thank you.